is reporting ready for launch. We have ignition.
Hey there, Mr. Bill Poker Peeps. Welcome to the vlog. What a great time I'm having playing cards lately. Oh my gosh, I'm just on fire. Anyhow, I'm going to give you guys a choice. A, B, or C. Who is the real Rocket Man? Maybe I should say the Rockets Man, because I have been playing a club called Rockets. I played there 6 times. I have never lost. Played there this week and I just crushed it. I ran so good. In fact, I ran so good it's ridiculous. You're not even going to believe some of these things. So, Mr. Bill, the real Rockets Man this week. So, come along. Let's take a look at some of this poker. All right, Friday, December 7th, I went over to Rockets in the evening. It's a 1-2-5 game, so it plays like a small 2-5. I buy in for $500. So early on, I have ace, nine of clubs on the button. I have $600. I make it 15. The big blind calls. His name is Jordan. He plays very, very loose. He deals there. Very loose player. The flop comes 9-8 deuce. He checks. I make it 15. He raises me up to 45. I've got top pair, top kicker. I ain't going nowhere. So I make the call. The turn is a 7. He leads out for 40. He doesn't have very much money. So I shove all in for his effective stack of only 140, $100 more. He doesn't like it. He says he was bluffing, but he hit the 7 on the turn. He tanks and he tanks. He finally calls with 5-7. The river's a jack, and I stack him off. All right, on this next hand, I have ace, king of diamonds. I'm in middle position, too. I have $700. There's a button straddle to 10. The plus one makes the call. I'm next. I decide I'm going to make the call. I don't like to play ace, king out of position, and these players are pretty aggressive. If somebody bumps it up, then I'm more than happy to 4-bet. So let's see what happens. The small blind and the big blind both call, and the button checks his option. So there's 5 of us to the flop, $50 in the pot. It comes ace of spades, ace of hearts, 8 of clubs. It checks around. The turn is the 9 of clubs. It goes check, check to the plus one, who makes it 20. I raise it up to 60. Everybody else folds. The plus one makes the call, and she says, man, I really need to hit here. The river with 170 in the pot is the 4 of diamonds, and she donk bets into me for 100. What could she possibly hit here? But she has $500 back. I can't really raise here. If I do, the only thing that's probably going to call me is a full house. So I make the call. I show my ace king, and she folds it up. I win a nice pot. Next hand against the same woman, and she's been pounding the drinks pretty good, so she is pretty drunk. I have king of clubs, 10 of clubs, in middle position one. I have $820. I really hadn't played very much in the last couple of orbits. So this woman, who's not a very good player, is under the gun, and she limps in. I make it $20. The cutoff and this woman under the gun make the call. The flop with 63 in the pot comes ace of hearts, queen of diamonds, 9 of clubs. The woman checks. I make it 25. Cutoff folds. And this woman tank, 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 calls. I think that means she's drawing. The turn is the 7 of hearts. She checks. I make it 55. And she says, you had better show me what you have. And she doesn't want to fold, but she reluctantly folds. I muck. I do not show. And she says that she's after me. Ooh, that's good. That's a good, good thing. Especially a player that plays too loose and may have had a couple too many drinky poos. All right, the last hand we're going to go over. I'm on the button with pocket nines. I have $850. Our very, very loose friend, Jordan, is under the gun and he's straddling for 10. The plus one and the hijack call. I would normally raise here, but I know that Jordan's probably going to raise on a 75% range here. So I make the call with every intention of 4-betting him if he makes a raise. Well, he does make a raise. He makes a raise to all in for $230. The other two players fold. So I think about it. I make sure I get a count. It's 230. And so I make the call, and here's why I do make the call. So Jordan is a very, very loose, crazy player, but he knows better than to shove with aces, kings, queens. He might have ace king, he might have ace queen, but he has got a ton of junk hands in his range. So if I give him the range that I show right here, I'm way ahead. And actually, this range may actually be too narrow. He may be even wider than this. But given this range, it's still a good call. So I just throw in one chip for the call, and Jordan says, aren't you going to put your money in? I said, I guarantee you, if I lose, I'll pay you. And he said, are you that confident? And I said, well, I think I'm ahead. The board comes 2-5-6-2-2. I turn over my pocket nines, kind of flicks the cards. I win, although he really was pretty close to what I think is what the top of his range would be for shoving. He had ace king. So once again, another nice result at Rockets. All right, it's pretty quiet at my work, and I'm quite far ahead on the project I'm working on. There's nobody there because it's Christmas time. So on Wednesday in the afternoon, I ran a few errands, and one of the errands was right next to Rockets, where I play in a club. So I decided I'd do a little bit of testing while I was playing poker. One game going, in fact, I made six, so we started with six of us. It's a 1-2-5 bring-in game, so it plays like a small 2-5. I think it's an unlimited cap, although I bought in for the most at 500. So this first hand on this Wednesday afternoon, let's do as a you be the villain. I'm in the plus one with $400. You are under the gun with king of clubs, jack of clubs. You make it $15. I make the call. The cutoff, the small blind, and the big blind all call. So the flop with $75 comes, ace of diamonds, ace of clubs, four of diamonds, it checks around. The turn comes a six of diamonds, it goes check, check to you, you make it 30, I make the call, everybody else folds. The river comes the king of clubs, you check, I put you all in for your a very small effective stack of 70, what do you do? I think this is a pretty easy fold for you, and that's what the player did. I had ace-king, and really the reason why I wanted to do this hand as a you be the villain is to tell you why I didn't raise pre-flop. So I personally do not like to raise ace-king if I'm out of position. If I'm in position, I will. And this is for cash games. Tournament, I played completely different, and I just rip it in there with ace-king. But cash game, I don't like to raise out of position, so a little bit stealthy, a little bit sneaky, certainly underrepresented. I didn't win very much money in this hand, but I have had other hands where I have played ace king very, very slowly like that preflop and have won a lot of money. So that's just my philosophy. I don't like to play ace king out of position and bloat the pot. Don't like it. All right, the next hand, I'm in the plus one with king of clubs, seven of clubs, playing 700. I have 500 in the plus one. I make it 15, middle position one, hijack and button, all call. The flop with $63 in the pot comes seven of diamonds, seven of hearts, king of diamonds. I guess that would be bingo bongo. It checks around. The turn is the six of diamonds. I make it 20. Two players fold, and the other guy calls. The river with 103 in the pot. Hey, let's get the fourth seven. It's the seven of spades. I make it 40. He folds, but this was important because I won the high hand of the day. Just found out that it held up, and I get a free entry into a tournament in 2 weeks, and I don't know if there's a bonus for the high hand or not other than that, but I'll find out. But anyhow, high hand, quad sevens with a king. All right, this club, like many clubs, does one hand of dealer's choice per round. On this particular one, we're playing PLO 8. I am on the button with 10 of diamonds, 9 of diamonds, 9 of clubs, jack of clubs. I have $650. Not a great hand for PLO 8. I'd like it a lot better than just regular old PLO. But there's five of us at $10, so it wasn't expensive. The flop with 50 in the pot comes jack of diamonds, eight of diamonds, three of clubs. I flop open-ended straight flush draw. That's not bad. Folds to the cutoff, who makes it $10. I make the call. The under the gun and the middle position one call. The turn with $90 in the pot. I run pretty good at Rockets. Seven of diamonds, straight flush. It checks all the way around to me. I make it very, very small, $30. And then all of a sudden the cutoff announces, raise. What? There's two other players left to act. Anyhow, the other gun calls, knowing she's going to raise. The other guy folds. She then makes it 120. Man, is this fantastic for me or what? I make the call, and the under the gun makes the call. The river with 450 in the pot is the king of clubs, and the cutoff says, all right, I got the low. What? What are you doing? So we all say, no! There has to be betting after each card. Anyhow, now it checks to me. She didn't even bet after she's saying she has the low, so she obviously didn't have the nut low. I want to get some value. I bet 200. The under the gun tanks and tanks and tanks. He's actually calculating whether or not if he gets quartered on the low, whether it's still worth it. He ends up making the call. The cutoff goes all in for her effective of 185. The under the gun had ace deuce for the nut low. The cutoff had ace four for second nut low. Just a very, very strangely played hand. I obviously have the high with my straight flush. The cutoff wasn't really very happy because she said, I don't really know how to play Omaha. Her betting kind of told us that. All right, the next interesting hand is close to the time I have to leave for my league game. I have $900 in the small blind with eight of spades, eight of diamonds. The under the gun, who starts the hand with $150, makes it 15, the plus one and the button call. I bump it up to 65. The under the gun, who is the shorty, is the only one to call. So I can already tell you, it doesn't matter what the flop is, I'm going to go all in. He's only got $85 left. It doesn't matter what happens, I am getting it in there. So the flop comes, 10 of spades, 10 of clubs, 3 of spades. Very, very good flop for pocket eights. I put it all in there for his effective of 85. He makes the call, and the river comes, jack of hearts, king of clubs. Oh my gosh. How can I possibly win this hand unless he has an underpair to my eights? I mean, any Broadway gets there. Ace queen gets there. Any single Broadway gets there. But because I run good at rockets, he has ace of spades, five of spades for a missed flush draw, and I win this one too. So played 3 hours at rockets, made a net profit of $605, plus I got the high hand for an entry into that tournament, so I liked it very, very much. I will certainly be going back during the day. Then I was off to get a bite to eat, and then on to my Wednesday night poker league, where we had some more Mr. Bill goodness. So Wednesday night poker league, I have not been recording for my vlog. It's the one day I can play that I just relax and I don't worry about recording hands or anything. But I do want to tell you about a couple of hands because I remember them, not because I recorded them. Anyhow, went for the tournament, didn't do well, got to the cash game. I was down $400 within about 20 minutes. And this is in a very small little 1-2 game with a $200 max. So you can see I didn't start off too good. So one of the hands that contributed to me not doing so well, I had ace eight of clubs in the cutoff. I folded around to me. I made it $15. One of my previous vlog watchers, now my friend Randy Hayes, who does not like to fold to me, is in the small blind. He makes the call, and the big blind made the call also. So we had $45 in the pot to a flop of 10-9-4. They both checked to me. I made it 20. Randy calls. The other guy folds. The turn was a jack, and it went check, check. The river is a second 10. I think this is a really good card for me. He checks to me. I make it $55, and he absolutely snap calls with 4-5. That's Randy. Randy's, he's always after me. Hey, but later on, one of my comeback hands was against Randy also, where I was in the big blind with two of diamonds, five of diamonds. Randy, I believe, was under the gun. He made it 15. There was four of us in the pot, including me, for $15. So the flop was $60 in the pot came five of clubs, five of hearts, eight of hearts. That is pretty darn good. It goes check, check to Randy, who makes it 35. The other two players fold. And I decide to simply make the call here. Thought about raising to try and represent hearts, but did not do it. The turn is a 3. I believe Randy bets 40. I raise it up to like 95. He makes the call. The river, a deuce. So now I have a full house. He checks. I put him all in. I think he had like $100 left. He did not like it, but he makes the call with an overpaired jacks, I believe, and of course by full house win. So I got a little bit of revenge back on my buddy Randy. I also won a monster PLO 8 pot in my Wednesday Poker League, where I think it was about a $1,500 pot. Ended up chopping it. I had the nut low, and I had it the whole way against two other players who were vying for the high. All told, I was in for $600 at Wednesday Poker League cash game and out for $1,560 for a $960 win. Not bad in a 1-2 game. All right, Friday, December 14th, I decided to go to Rockets again in the evening. I went about 10:30, so I knew it was going to be a relatively short session. Same game, 1-2-5. I buy in for 500. I run so good at Rockets. So for the first two orbits, I hardly play any hands. I'm playing at a table where I don't know as many of the people as I do sometimes. Anyhow, I get pocket sixes in middle position two. I have $480. There's a button straddle to 10. The end of the gun makes the call. MP1 makes the call. I bump it up to 40. Comes back around. The big blind makes it 100. Both these guys fold. I don't know what I had thought of this guy yet. Anyhow, I made the call. I don't know if that's right or not. He didn't really have that much money behind it. I think he had only 400. But the button was still left, and he was calling everything, and he folds. So the flop with 231 in the pot comes 10-9-7. Really not horrible for pocket sixes. He leads out for 100. Very strange. Man, if he had blasted it all in there, I think I might have folded, but I can't fold for 100, so I make the call. The turn, 431 in the pot. Bingo, bongo, it's an 8. I have a straight. As long as he doesn't have jacks, I think I'm good here. He shoves all in for 260. There's no way I'm folding now with the straight, right? So I make the call. He looks very disgusted. The river's an ace. He gets stacked off. He has pocket kings. I am the Rockets man. Man, I run so good there. It's ridiculous. This session at Rockets is interesting, not necessarily for the hands that I won, but the hands I didn't win. All right, so the next interesting hand, I'm in middle position one, ace of clubs, queen of hearts. I have $840. Again, there's a button straddle for 10. Under the gun calls, I decide I'm just going to call here. Guys are so aggressive, I think that they're probably going to raise later, and I'll see what to do. The big blind, who's probably the tightest player at the table, then makes it 45. The next guy folds. My spidey senses were telling me, just get out. I know I should never really fold ace-queen for another $35 here, but I folded. The button went ahead and made the call. So with 111 in the pot, the flop comes ace-queen-7. I'm kind of kicking myself. The under the gun leads out for 40. The other guy folds, and the under the gun shows pocket aces. He had like $400. I would have lost all $400 to him on a top two flop, so go with your gut. It's usually right. And only a few hands later, I am under the gun with ace of hearts, queen of clubs, ace queen again. I have $800. I bump it up to 20. The player to my left, who's really a very, very good player, played with him a couple of times, and he's just solid. He makes the call, and alarm bells are going off for me. He has flatted so many times with ace-king or whatever. The small blind makes the call. So the flop with 62 in the pot comes ace of clubs, king of hearts, five of hearts. The small blind checks. Again, I'm not feeling really very comfortable with this player behind me. I think something's up. I make the check, and he overbets the pot to 100. The other guy folds. I tank. I say I have a really, really good hand here. I have the ace of hearts, though, so is he really doing this with a flush draw? I don't think so. So I make the fold, another big fold with ace queen, and he turns over. Pocket aces. He said he didn't want a flush drawn out on him. So in like one orbit or two orbits, I folded ace queen, two big hands to pocket aces both times. Go with your gut, people. So after my well-documented struggles earlier this year, I am obviously turned it around. I'm in the black. Remember, I'm trying to have a $5,000 December, and I'm doing very, very well. I have a Mike Postol-like 17 wins in my last 20 cash sessions. Very, very good. I obviously had that very nice run at the World Series of Poker main event, which certainly helped my bottom line and what my graph looks like this year. Actually, it looks just like a U. That's not so good. Maybe it looks like a fish hook because the top of the U is bigger now. Once again, I'll be playing quite a bit of poker in December at the clubs, at Windstar. I may even take a trip somewhere and play in Vegas or Florida or something. We're going to see about that. Billy's coming home. He'll be playing with me in the Dallas area. So if you guys see us, please give us a shout out. Say hello. We love to talk to you guys. So it is always fun. So with that, we're going to end this vlog. Once again, as always, thank you guys so much for watching and subscribing and pressing buttons. Thanks for being Mr. Bill Poker Peeps. All right, you guys have a fantastic, wonderful, and blessed week, and I will see you next time. Bye.
We have ignition.